Hey, Michael Church here with thecrawlspaceninja.com, and in this video, I'm going to share with you a little bit about efflorescence. What is that? Well, it's something you might need to know about if you got a wet basement or a wet crawl space that you're dealing with, and you're getting ready to sell your house. Stay tuned. So I recently received this email from Jane, who lives in Knoxville, and she writes, "Hi Michael, we had a current home inspection and the home inspector found efflorescence in our block wall in our crawl space. They were recommending that we take care of the problem in order to sell the house. What should we do?" Well, that's a great question, Jane. And first of all, just so you know, efflorescence is not mold. We've done test after test on that, and it never comes up as mold, so you don't have to worry about that. What it is, though, is it's an indication of a water problem, either recently or in the past. The calcium inside of the cinder block gets pushed out of the cinder block or the concrete and is visible on the wall whenever you have static pressure pushing that water out of the ground and into the cinder block wall of the crawl space. Now, first of all, I want to describe what exactly efflorescence is. So here's what it says. Efflorescence is dissolved salts deposited on the surface of a material such as concrete or brick that are visible after the evaporation of water in which it was transported. The moisture that creates efflorescence often comes from groundwater, but rainwater can also be the source. Efflorescence does not pose a major problem, but it can be an indication of a moisture intrusion problem. So what all does that mean? Well, what that means for you is if you just recently had a home inspector that went into the crawl space or the basement and they saw this white chalky stuff all over the walls of the basement and crawl space, then they're like, "Oh no, we've got a water intrusion problem. I'm going to write that on my report." Well, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's a current water intrusion problem. It could have happened 20 years ago and you fixed it whenever you had your downspouts and your gutters corrected, okay? So it may not be an issue. So what you have to do is you have to check the moisture level of the cinder block or the concrete, and that's done with a moisture meter. The other thing you got to be sure of is that how do you address the problem in the first place? Well, you may decide to put some kind of paint over it or something like that, but just be aware that if you do any kind of cover-up like that and you do have an active water intrusion problem and the paint is not able to withstand that intrusion, the static pressure that's coming through, the paint itself can become a mold food, and then not only do you have efflorescence on the block behind the paint, but now you got mold growing on that paint that you just installed, and we don't want that. Now remember just a few minutes ago I said efflorescence itself isn't mold, that salt that comes through the cinder block isn't mold, but if you've got an active moisture problem, that moisture that's coming through the cinder block, the brick, or the concrete wall is evaporating into the space. So if you've got a basement or a crawl space, what is that doing? It's raising the humidity. And we all know what humidity level mold can grow at, right? 60%, that's right. So what you got to do is if you have an active moisture problem and you tested the wall and it's wet and every time you get a rainstorm it seems it's getting worse and worse, you may want to install a dehumidifier in there to control that humidity so that you don't have secondary damage on your joist or your drywall depending on whether it's a crawl space or a basement. So that would be a good idea to make sure you install a dehumidifier as quickly as possible to address at least the secondary damage of possible mold growing in that space. So to answer her question, what can she do to fix this problem? Well, you can use an epoxy waterproofing paint, all right, which I don't really recommend because, like I said earlier, if that static pressure pushes through, it's going to cause a mold problem in the future. But basically, what you have to do is you have to make sure that the gutters and the downspouts are draining away from the house. You want to make sure the slope of the yard is away from the foundation of the house. You know, just the basic things to make sure the water isn't actively coming into the space, whether it's a basement or a crawl space. But what we do in crawl spaces that seems to satisfy the issue here with these home inspectors is you can encapsulate the crawl space. Well, I really appreciate you all watching this video, and I hope that gives you a little bit of information about how to deal with efflorescence, okay? So again, it's not a big deal in most cases as long as it's not an active water intrusion problem. If it is active, then it could be causing a humidity issue, so you want to get it taken care of as quickly as possible. If it's a basement, you may have to go with some sort of interior basement waterproofing or perhaps an exterior basement waterproofing system in order to keep that water from coming through the cinder block. So keep an eye on those block walls and those concrete walls and the brick for some of the older houses in the crawl spaces and basements to make sure you don't have an efflorescence problem. Please, if you don't mind, like this video down below. I'd really appreciate it. And if you have any comments or anything, let me know. Home inspectors, you know, mold inspectors, other people in our industry, I invite you to chime in and let us know what you think about these videos. And if you have any direct issues that you need to get in touch with me with, you can contact me through the YouTube channel. And I hope you like it and have a great day. Hey, Michael Church here, and I'm here with Willie, and we did some work on his crawl space. So, Willie, you were just telling me that your house is more comfortable now. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Oh, yes. Since I had the enclosure done, the dehumidifier put in that you guys set up for me, it has been amazingly cold.
Oh, wow.
We put a new air filter that you guys also supplied me, told me about some of the problems I could caulk up, did those things. Once you guys got done with your product, it was greatly improved. I can sit at 71 degrees, and it feels like it's almost 60.
Wow, that's amazing. Now, just so you know, it is summertime, so we're wanting it cold in the summer down there. So you mentioned the air filter, the AirSafe 2000, so you like that too, huh?
Yes, AirSafe 2000 was an almost instant, you know, it was an instant improvement.
Oh, wow, very good.
And just the way the air, the way it sounds, it is working out absolutely great. I couldn't imagine doing without it.
That's great. Well, thanks, Willie, for letting me get your video testimonial. One last question. How are the guys to work with?
Absolutely. Professionals all the way through. Oh, always great. Wanted to make sure that I was aware of the process, what was going on. they even tried to make me crawl down in there once they were done. But I just looked back in there. They explained the dehumidifier to me. Absolute professionals.
Great. Well, that's wonderful. Well, thanks again, Willie, and thanks for watching the review.
Thank you.